Good morning, everyone. Today I am going to teach class 9 mathematics. I am going to continue sums of exercise 1.3, that is first chapter, from sum number 8. So you can see the sum. You have to change recurring decimals into fractions, that is in the form p by q. So let us see the question number 8 in your book. Come to this question number 8. You follow, express the following numbers in the form p by q, where p and q are both integers and q is not equal to 0. So let us take first question number 1, 0.3 recurring. So 0.3 bar, that you can write, is equal to 0.333, it will continue. So let us take x is equal to 0.3333. Now, since here only one number is repeating, therefore you have to bring the decimal here after one place. That means you have to bring the decimal here after 3. So what you have to do is, you multiply both the sides by 10. So you, the next step then, 10x is equal to 3.3333. It will continue. Let this be second equation and this one be first equation. I have written here multiplying both the sides by 10. Now you subtract equation 1 from equation 2. So you write minus x is equal to 0.3333 and subtract this. So you get here, then 9x is equal to 3. So ultimately, therefore, you get x is equal to 3/9, reduce it, and then you get x is equal to 1/3. So this way you can express this recurring decimal into fraction. So 0.3 bar is equal to 1/3. Now next sum number, third one I have taken here, you have to change this one 0.404040 into in the form p by q. Again same way, you take, suppose x is equal to 0.404040, so you find then here two numbers are repeating here. In the first case there was only one number, in this second one you have two numbers, 4 and 0 is repeating. So you have to bring the decimal after two places here then, since two numbers are repeating. That means you write 40.4040. That means this way, to write this way, you have to multiply both sides by 100. So you write here, so this is your first equation, this is your second equation. So I have written here, as there are two repeating digits after decimal, so multiply both sides by 100. Come to the sum again. Here I am focusing only the particular sum, because otherwise your video will not come clear. You also copy that way. Now this is second equation. Now subtract the first equation from second equation. So write x is equal to 0.404040 and subtract. And you get here 100 minus x, so you get 99x is equal to 40.000. So you get therefore x is equal to 40/99. So this is your answer. This way you can convert recurring decimals into the form p by q. So two sums I explain this way. This you can do by using formula also. So one or two sums I'll show you how can you convert this by using formula. So this is number 8, fifth sum given 0.134, you have bar over 3 and 4. So two recurring digits. Now here you have written here 0, 1, 3, 4, all the numbers together. All the digits have to get written together minus non-recurring digit, that is 1. Okay, that is non-recurring here. So subtract that non-recurring digit here. Then divide by 10 to the power the number of digits after decimal. After decimal you have 3 digits, so 10 to the power 3 minus 10 to the power the number of non-recurring digits after decimal. Here now non-recurring digits only you have 1. 1 is only one non-recurring, so you write 10 to the power 1. And you solve it now, you get here, therefore, 133 divided by 1000 minus 10. Okay, so you get is equal to 133 by 990. So you cannot reduce it anymore, so that is your answer. Let us solve one more sum. I am giving here, I have taken one example. Sum, the number is 3.124, you have bar over 2 and 4. So two numbers are repeating, 2 and 4. Same way again here, use the formula. I have written the formula here down. So you can check the formula and can do this also. Written the formula, all digits written together minus non-recurring digits. Divide by 10 to the power number of digits after decimal minus 10 to the power number of non-recurring digits after decimal. So here, you same way, you write the number non-recurring, recurring, all the digits you write together 3124 minus only non-recurring digit, that is 31. Decimal you avoid. Divide by 10 to the power 3. Why? Because now number of digits after decimal you have 3 digits, 1, 2, 4. So don't write the digits, only number of digits. So 3 digits, so write 3 here. Minus 10 to the power 1. Why? Because the formula it tells the number of non-recurring digits after decimal. So here only one digit. So you 10 to the power 1. Now solve it. You subtract 3093 divided by 1000 minus 10 is equal to 3093 divided by 990. Reduce it again. You get 1031 divided by 330. That is your last answer. Alright?